In this problem, we're going to learn how to solve for biochemical oxygen demand, or BOD for short. Well, let's go to the board and see how to work out this BOD problem. Well, the problem reads, a secondary effluent has a total BOD of 45 milligrams per liter. A BOD test is run on this same secondary effluent at the same time using a nitrification inhibitor. Using the data for this test as given below, calculate the nitrogenous BOD. We're supposed to assume that a 300 milliliter BOD bottle is used to run this test. Well, they told us that our total BOD was 45 milligrams per liter. Now, there's two types of BOD that make up the total BOD. We have carbonaceous BOD and nitrogenous BOD. And when you add this nitrification inhibitor, you're determining the carbonaceous BOD. So what we will do is we will calculate the carbonaceous BOD using the data given, and then we'll take the difference between our carbonaceous BOD and the total BOD, and that'll be the nitrogenous BOD. Well, some things we need to know before we work this problem are, we have to make sure that the test is a valid test. And the first thing we look at is our blank. When you set this up, you'll set up a blank bottle to see if there's any depletion without adding any sample. Well, in our problem here, our blank dissolved oxygen at the beginning was 9 milligrams per liter, and after the 5-day test, we still had 8.9 milligrams per liter in the bottle. Well, we need our depletion in the blank to be 0.2 or less, 0.2 milligrams per liter or less. So in this case, going from 9 to 8.9, we see a depletion of 0.1 milligrams per liter. So that's acceptable. So now we have to look at each individual bottle to see if it meets the other two criteria. When we look at the 50 mil and the 30 mil samples, we need to see that we have at least a 0.2 milligram per liter of dissolved oxygen depletion from beginning to end. And we also have to have at least 1 milligram per liter left in the bottle at the end of the test. Well, looking at this data, both the 30 mil and the 50 mil have both depleted 0.2 milligrams per liter, and there's at least 1 milligram per liter of dissolved oxygen left in each. So we're going to use both of these sample bottles to calculate our carbonaceous BOD. What we'll do is we'll calculate the 30 milliliter sample BOD, then we'll calculate the 50 milliliter sample BOD, add them together, and divide by 2 to find the average. Then we can subtract that from our total, and we'll have our answer. Well, the formula we're going to use is our BOD formula. To find BOD in milligrams per liter, we use the formula that says our initial dissolved oxygen minus the final dissolved oxygen times 300 milliliters, which is the size of the sample bottle, divided by the milliliters of sample added to the bottle. So in this first case, we use the 30 milliliter data. So our initial dissolved oxygen was 8.9 milligrams per liter, and our final was 6.0. So we subtract the 6 milligrams per liter from the 8.9, we multiply that by the 300, and then divide by the 30 mils, and we see that our BOD in this instance is 29 milligrams per liter. Well, now we need to do the other sample, the 50 milliliter sample setup. The initial dissolved oxygen was 8.8 milligrams per liter, and then the final was 4.2 milligrams per liter. So we take the difference of those two, multiply by 300, and then divide by the 50 milliliter sample size. And when we do that, we see that this BOD was 27.6 milligrams per liter. Well, now that we have both of these samples, we're going to average them to get our result. So we're going to add the 29 milligrams per liter to the 27.6 milligrams per liter and divide by 2. And when we do that, you see that our result is 28.3 milligrams per liter. Now this 28.3 milligrams per liter represents our carbonaceous BOD. Well, they told us that the total BOD was 45 milligrams per liter. So if we take our carbonaceous BOD of 28.3 and subtract it from that 45, we'll have our nitrogenous BOD. So the formula looks like this. NBOD, or nitrogenous BOD, is equal to our total BOD minus our carbonaceous BOD. And when we do that, we see that our nitrogenous BOD is 16.7 milligrams per liter. And that, my friend, is how this problem is solved.